Welcome back to the oneAPI channel. Any developer today has access to very powerful heterogeneous parallel systems. Almost every cloud provider can provide you a system containing multiple CPUs, GPUs, AI accelerators, or FPGAs. The challenge is how to program these systems. Sometimes it requires very specific expertise. This is exactly what the developers community is fixing with oneAPI. One option is to use SYCL. Check out our video series on direct programming using C++ with SYCL. Another way is to use parallel heterogeneous primitives from the oneDPL library. Let me tell you all about it. In previous videos, we've talked about the oneAPI components. We mentioned the multi-device, multi-vendor OpenSpec libraries that can now work not only on CPU, but on multiple devices and vendors, and are packed into toolkits, the base toolkit, for example. That includes, among other, the oneAPI Data Parallel C++ library, what we call oneDPL. There are three ways to use the oneDPL library. The first one is to directly use a oneDPL library function, so you could execute C++ 17 parallel algorithms and C++ STL functions, not only on the CPU, but also on GPU, FPGA, and other devices. I'll show you an example in a minute. The second is for a device kernel code. If I'm using C++ with SQL and I have this queue, an execution queue to the device, I can submit code to be executed on that device. But what code can that device execute? A GPU or an FPGA, for example, cannot run any kind of code. Well, if you're using primitives from the oneDPL library, they are tested and guaranteed to work on the supported devices. And the third way is by the Intel Compatibility tool. If you're migrating legacy CUDA code to C++ with SQL so it can run not only on a specific GPU, but on CPU, GPU, FPGA, and more, the tool, called today SQLomatic, will also use primitives from the oneDPL library. Take a look at the video on the compatibility tool. It is also part of the oneAPI base toolkit. So, oneDPL basically implements the C++ algorithms library using SQL. There are many things to talk about. You can use buffers or unified shared memory. There are custom iterations. There are more than 100 standard C++ APIs and many range-based and asynchronous functions implemented for Linux, Mac, or Windows. Tons of materials available. If you navigate to oneAPI.io, you can find the spec of oneDPL, the algorithms, extensions to STL, and more. The oneDPL GitHub page is also a good place to look for the code, for examples, and documentation. Maybe the easiest way to start is on the Intel Dev Cloud. Zero installs and zero settings. I will open a sample in VS Code. Take a look on our video on VS Code extensions. Look for the oneAPI logo. We can now browse for the sample code we need. Get started, direct programming, the libraries, oneDPL. This is a gamma correction sample. Let's open it in another window. For this sample, the solution has to be built in Visual Studio. You can take a look at the code. If you follow the instructions, you'll get the fractal image here on the left and the same image on the right after gamma correction. But I will try to show you a simpler example. I'll just run it here in Visual Studio with the same setting. Let's start with a standard C++ code. I have here a big vector data, and I'm going to use this lambda function to basically fill this vector with random numbers using generate. And then I'll sort that vector from begin to end. Let's build it. That's all. And now let's add execution policy. We'll add sequential policy and apply it to both functions, build a solution, and run. And one thread was executed. If we change the execution policy to parallel, build, and run, You can see that multiple threads were executed, so we have parallel programming. And now, let's do heterogeneous programming. We'll use the execution and algorithms from oneDPL. We'll take the policy from oneAPI, oneDPL, DPCPP, underscore default. We'll basically offload to my GPU. We cannot use it for generate, as random numbers generation is not supported by any STL function, but the sort should work. Let's build and run, and you can see that my GPU is being used for the sort function. Pretty cool. I took standard C++ code, and with one line of policy change, I offloaded the sort function from the CPU to the GPU. Can it be easier than that? OneDPL. I hope you'll find it useful. Thank you.